our mission is
leading change, challenging minds, transforming lives.
Kicking things off with our icebreaker, pause and record your advisory response to the following question.
All right, Jets, it's Principal Strickland here with your Wednesday motivational moment. And this quote lines up directly with the fact that we have 6 more days left in this term. And here's the quote: nothing is given to you. Everything is earned. You have to have that mindset that you must work every single day and learn every single day. And that's by Saquon Barkley. And so from that, we all should have to understand that in life, nothing is given to you. There is no free meal. There is nothing that's just going to happen for you without some hard work. So you can't get good grades if you don't work hard. You can't live a fabulous lifestyle if you don't put in some work. And so we need you all to understand that hard work absolutely always pays off. And so if you work hard now with building good habits, with focusing on your studies, with being a good person, with being organized, all of those things are going to pay off. So continue to work hard if you want to earn the things that are worth having in life. So your grades, your report card, no teacher gives you those grades. Those are the grades that you earn. And so make sure that you're putting in your best effort so you can continue to be successful. So that's the motivational quote for today. Couple of reminders. So make sure your parents have signed up for Parent Square. We send a lot of messages, give a lot of information so that everyone is well informed of what's going on here at Charles Hart Middle School. So couple of things. We do have a game on Thursday versus McKinley. First, I want to give a huge shout out. Our girls and boys basketball team left it all on the floor tonight. I'm super proud of you all. Our last home game of the season is on Thursday versus McKinley. And if you want to be able to be in the stands, make sure you're on your best soaring behavior in order to get a wristband. On next Monday, January the 23rd, they will be having the memorial service for Ms. Radden. And it's going to take place at the First Baptist Church of the Glen Arden Worship Center in Lanham on Brightseat Road. The viewing is 10 a.m. and the actual service is at 11 a.m. And I've already let your parents know, and we're going to send a couple of reminders, that on Monday there will be very, very, very limited a number of people from Hart Middle School here in the building. So if you so happen to show up on Monday, you probably will be greeted by people who do not work at Hart. So it's up to you and your parents to determine what's going to be best for you as it relates to where you should be on Monday. If you do show up to school on Monday, you all will be working on your missing work, because on Tuesday, that's the last day of term 2. So on Monday, you and your family decide where you should be on that day, but know that more than 75% of the Hart Middle School staff will not be in the building, because we will all be paying our respects to our beloved friend, colleague, mentor, awesome, dynamic, super dope, phenomenal teacher, Ms. Radden. So on Monday, you and your family decide what's going to be best for you. Just know we won't be here. Tuesday will be a regular day of school as we wrap up term two. And then there's no school on Wednesday because it is a teacher professional day for teachers. So they'll be working on putting their grades in and closing out their grade books. On Thursday, we're going to come back in here and it's going to be term three. Can y'all believe it? We're already at term three. And so if nothing else, ladies and gentlemen, if you haven't buckled down, now is the time to buckle down, because everything as it relates to promotion is riding on what happens during term three and term four. So please make sure you all are prepared and ready. Also, this Friday, your teachers are going to give you a printout so you're going to know what your grades are if you have missed an assignment, so that if you and your parent chooses for you to stay home on Monday, you will have everything that you need to work and get it done so you can turn it all in on Tuesday, which is the last day of the term. All right. Well, these are all of my announcements that I have. Have a magnificent Wednesday.
All right, Jet, so we'll be jumping into habit one, being proactive, starting with the proper way to greet people. Here are the materials needed. Teachers, make sure that you have the synonym cards, a hard copy of this lesson plan, and everyone has an engaging attitude. Let's jump right in.
First, let's talk about it. Why do you think it is important to greet someone properly? I'm going to start a 2-minute timer. I want you guys to discuss this amongst your peers and with your advisory teachers. Timer starts in 3, 2, 1. All right, now we're going to move into the practice round. Teachers, follow the discussion portion of the lesson plan. While you guys do that, I'm going to play one of my favorite greeting songs in 3, 2, 1.
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Wake up, Mr. West, Mr. West, Mr. Fresh, Mr. By himself, he's so impressed. I mean, did you even see the test? You got D's, motherfucker, D's. Rosie Perez, and yes, barely passed. Class, looking at every app, cheated on every test. I guess this is my dissertation, homie. This is basic. Welcome to.
nation. Good morning. Legendary, everything we dreamed of. I'm like the fly Malcolm X, buy any jeans necessary. Detroit red cleaned up from the streets of the league, from an eighth to a key. But you graduate when you make it up out of the streets. From the moments of pain, look how far we done came. Haters saying you changed, now you doing your thing. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Look at the valedictorian. Scared of the future while I hop in the DeLorean. Scared to face the world, complacent career student. Some people graduate but be still stupid. They tell you read this, eat this. Don't look around, just peep this. Preach this, teach us Jesus. Okay, look up now. They done stole your streetness. After all of that, you receive this. Good morning.
Hustlers, that's if you're still living. Get on down.
Every time that we hit them, good morning.
Hustlers, that's if you're still living. Get on down.
Every time that we hit them, good morning.
Hustlers, that's if you're still living. Get on down.
Every time that we hit them, good morning.
Hustlers, that's if you're still living. Get on down. Get on down.
Now that we got the practice out of the way, it's time for the real thing. Teachers, pass out synonym cards to each student face down. Students, do not look at your word yet. Once our timer or music video starts, students must find the partner whose word matches their words. Once you find your partner, greet each other and share one fun fact about yourself. Let's begin in 3, 2, 1.
My cousin's ceremony is tonight.
What's his gift?
We're gonna find out.
What's your gift?
Who's asking?
Us?
Well, us. I can't just talk about myself. I'm only part of the amazing Madrigals.
Who's all the amazing Madrigals?
You're not gonna leave me alone, are you? Casita, help me out. Drawers. Floors. Doors. Let's go. This is our home. We've got every generation. So full of music, rhythm of its own design. This is my family, a perfect constellation. So many stars and everybody gets to shine. Whoa! Let's be clear up while I run this show. Whoa! She led us here so many years ago. Whoa! And every year our family blessings grow. There's just a lot you simply got to know. So, welcome to family Madrigal. The home of the family Madrigal. Why coffee's for grown-ups. Might be a bad mom, her mood affects the weather. When she's unhappy, well, the temperature gets weird. Might be a Bruno.
We don't talk about Bruno.
They say he saw the future. One day he disappeared. Oh! And that's why mom, we get that, here's her deal. Whoa! The truth is she can heal you with a meal. Whoa! Her recipes are remedies for real. If you're impressed, imagine how I feel, mom. Welcome to the family Madrigal, the home of the family Madrigal. Hey, coming through! I know it sounds a bit fantastical and magical, but I'm part of family Madrigal. You guys fell in love with family Madrigal, and now they're part of
the family Madrigal.
Silvio, Felix, Mary, Beppa, and my dad married Julieta. That's all Abuela became an
Abuela Madrigal.
Let's go.
We swear to always help those around us and earn the miracle growing. The world keeps turning, but work and dedication will keep the miracle burning. And each new generation must keep the miracle burning.
Wait, who's a sister and who's a cousin?
There's so many people.
How do you keep them all straight?
Okay. So many kids in our house, so let's turn the sound up. You know why? I think it's time for a grand kids round up.
Grand kids round up.
Cousin Dolores can hear a pin drop. Camilo shakes, Antonio gets his gift today. My older sisters,
Isabella and Luisa.
One strong, one graceful, perfect in every way.
All right, students, that wraps up our advisory lesson for this week. Here is our exit ticket. Using the sentence stems on the lesson plans, teachers, record and share what was learned today. I'm looking forward to seeing all that you guys learned about greetings today. See you guys next week, same time, same place. Bye.